And so they were fighting with swords, and finally when they came face to face on both the army, so many people died. One king ultimately was successful in putting that other king down. And he was about to hit him, cut his neck. But that king which fell down was got really angry, and spitted on this king, on this king's face. The moment he did that, this king who was about to hit stopped, threw his sword, went back. Quite surprising. Why should he do that? He should, after such a hard work, he was about to be successful in killing that king, and this fellow has thrown his sword and gone. This king who was safe went home, but he was not happy. वो कहते हैं ना दया की मेरे पे, मुझे मारा नहीं. He was not happy. I don't want such things. I will go and ask why he didn't kill me. So this fellow went and asked that king, and he said, look, when you spitted on me, I developed anger. I got angry. And under the influence of anger, doing any action would be wrong, adharma. And so I didn't do that. I threw away the sword. Now this was quite a strong answer, very good. And that really influenced this other king. And he felt that, no, such a person who is on the path of dharma, who is functioning with level-headed mind, who has heightened awareness, because even at the time of fight, his awareness is very strong, that look, anger came in my mind, so I am not supposed to do any action. That is real yogi. And he gave all the kingdom and he joined hands with him, and they both started functioning together. So I just wanted to explain these few things, lots of things to talk, but the point is that let us understand one thing, that yoga is a science of health, and let us see that we don't bring yoga only at the level of physical. We have to live holistically. We have to see that we attend to all those things where our duty lies, and ultimately come to a level where we could go little deeper. Very rightly he pointed out pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi, ultimately that. Finally, the research was done, Dr. Brasso from America. Very recently, some 30 years back, the paper came out, and very rightly he has pointed out that when person is quiet, one-pointed, slowly, slowly, if he stays in that position for some time, all the tension of the body automatically vanishes. So treatment of disease automatically takes. What is required is to treat diseases, to go within yourself, be peaceful, quiet, stop having too much of desires, and come to yourself. Know yourself, know your body, know your mind, and come quietly to yourself. Very often in a day, I very often tell people that whenever there is a time, sit for 2 minutes at least with closed eyes and go within yourself. Just be peaceful, stop thinking. Then think later on, but stop thinking. You are sitting and worrying, tell yourself, no, right now, no, I'll be quiet. It is not difficult. If you would bring yoga as doing for 1 hour, get up early in the morning and do some asanas, I would say no. Good sleep is most important for treatment of disease. Good sleep. But I would say that bring yoga into your day-to-day life. Whenever you are traveling, why do you have to keep your eyes open and look here and there? You have seen the world, no? Enough of it. Now close your eyes and just listen to the sound. Some sound. Wonderful it would be. So your mind is one-pointed, and that would be a medicine. Or whenever you are in a very fresh atmosphere, climate, take few deep breaths, slow inhalation and exhalation. That would help you. Or whenever possible, you don't have to speak, just listen. Listen more, speak less. So I should stop also. Speak less. And you will notice that would help in generating good amount of energy, and so on and so forth. So let's work on ourselves, There is no point in learning more and more asanas, no point in learning more and more pranayams. Few asanas are enough. Just see that your spine is flexible. Just see that your abdomen is under control, soft and in and not protruding out. Just see that your diet routines are somehow manageable, healthy. Go and watch your system, watch yourself and breath. And finally, do your duty joyfully, happily. And I tell you, health is very much a natural phenomenon. You will be healthy, but not just health is the criteria. You will be most peaceful, happy and useful person for the family, for the society, for the nation, for the humanity. Let's do right karmas in life just by becoming healthy. After that what? Okay, you are healthy, but then what? You have to do some right karmas, some right actions. So concentrate on karmas. Do some action. Entire Gita's message is what? Do your duty. Do your duty with best of your capacity. So let's all follow this path. And this is holistic path. This is what Yoga Institute is teaching since last 92 years. And now Radheshyam is taking over. Yoga Institute is quietly functioning there in a small little place, 1 acre land. But now Radheshyam will take it to the world, showing the right path. So, all the best. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you very much. Srimati Hansaji Jaydev Yogendra, we are overwhelmed by your benign presence.